Slady, what's going? I got down shirt or anything and shit. Bro, look at what I posted on my Twitter. Hey, y'all let me know if y'all want me to drop that shit. I ain't gonna care. I might just drop that shit. That shit hard. Anyways, hey, we got Mike Tyson and Lil Boosie. I ain't gonna cap. I did watch the interview like this morning, this afternoon. And I really was like confused and lost on it because the energy was so weird in the room. I really couldn't understand like what the hell was going on. And, like the black and white throws it all in as in. But anyways, we got the Mike Tyson and Lil Boosie. I think you like homosexuals.
Damn, I ain't young.
Hey, I already know they don't set Boosie up, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, and I watched the Vlad interview, it was like, they was trying to set up a meeting and clear up everything about what he said about Dwayne Wade's son and shit like that. So they got a big-ass finance nigga, Mike Tyson. Oh, let me go talk to Boosie, they don't set his ass up.
Like, you, I watch everything.
Why this nigga talk like that? Why he talk like his tongue big as fuck?
So, how do you feel about something?
You talk with this tongue out, nigga.
You know, I come from the slums, you know, back
then. No, I know we all come from the slums.
Yeah, I know we all come from the slums.
Like, it's something up.
This nigga voice got down worse than Donald Trump.
Well, let's talk about me.
Okay.
Hey, who y'all think will win in the fight? Mike Tyson or Boosie? I ain't gonna cap. I think it's gonna be a tie. I think Boosie gonna win. I think Boosie beat the fuck out of Mike Tyson.
Let's see. I'm from the slums too. You know what blew my mind when somebody, I had a hat, my mother bought me a hat in the 70s of Robin.
So he one of them weird little niggas that like, they used to do all the little weird shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, little weird shit like put glue on your hands and peel your motherfucker off. The goddamn eat the gun from under the desk and shit like that. He looked like one of them. You know what I'm saying?
Hood hat was a really fly hat to have. I must have been 9 or something. But for some reason, I had that innate, I like style, I like clothes, just out of the blue. I like clothes, and somebody punched me in my face. He became my good friend too, eventually. But he punched me in my face and took my hat, and that blew my mind. That blew my mind. And ever since then, I didn't understand the world, and people would pick on me, take my money. I became, not a nice person.
I feel like I lost brain cells hearing this nigga talk. I really think I lost brain cells hearing this nigga talk. It's like, I don't know. Maybe he know more than me. I don't know.
I heard people and it's just really bad stuff. But what happened? How did you? That's who I am now. I'm an insecure kid. I'm really scared all the time. But everybody thinks I'm fucking fearless.
What changed me? What happened to you?
Yeah. Why did you
a hustler?
No, it's not. Like the way you are now. That has nothing to do with hustle. It's the way you are now caused you to hustle. It's the way you think. The way you think about yourself and the world.
I just think about always going further in the world, you know.
I think about growing and evolving, being better than I was yesterday. You know what I'm saying? Get better every day. Work towards a goal. Go done with this shit. For sure. Hey, 10,000 subscribers, man. Y'all like, comment, subscribe, all that. Be going none but up. I'm telling you, I might fuck around be your favorite YouTube. Tell me. No kidding.
What's that? What's going further?
No kidding me. You know what I'm
saying? All this is just expanding. It's just making a better way for my kids. You know, I got a lot of hustle in me. I got a lot of hustle in me from always wanting when I was a kid. I always wanted when I was a kid.
Why did you want?
because nobody in my family really had. So I always wanted to look like Calvin, the drug dealers and shit. And now I just got a hunger for one more. That's just a part of me. I always want more. Like I don't never say.
Bro, I be feeling the same way, bro. Like I be wanting more shit. Like I have to do better than what I did. But like, you know what I'm saying, like we ain't going back now. We going number up, Tilly.
Hell for shit. I felt, you know, and then I came home from prison with nothing. And I came home with nothing, so I've been home 5 years, and I'm just refreshed. You know, I feel like prison made me a better man. It made me smarter.
When y'all get musty, what do it smell like? Do it smell like weed or gas? Do it smell like gas or gas? Like, do it smell like gas, weed, or do it smell like gas from the gas pump? My armpit, it be smell like plastic. It smell like plastic.
It made me a businessman. Yeah, good pack.
So what do you listen to? Oh, that's why I wanted to. How do you feel about other people's?
Hey, it's a nigga on my YouTube hating. Hey, and your nigga commented, trash video, you should quit. Nigga, let me look at your video, little nigga. Nigga, you don't got no video, little ugly ass boy. Do you have any money in your bank account, my nigga? I doubt it.
Feelings. You know, you offend a lot of people. Talk about fucking gay motherfuckers, homos, and
fags. No, a lot of times I need to shut the fuck up. It's just.
Why don't you?
I don't know, man. It be hard.
Why do you say things about person that might be a homosexual? Why do you say that about them? Do you feel the possibility that you're a homosexual and you might disrespect them?
Boy, what? It's somebody, this nigga Mike Tyson. He from them folks. Them, you know what I'm saying? They don't set Boosie up. They don't set my nigga Boosie up. The little shit they say they was gonna have with Jay-Z, they don't send them big ass ultimator nigga Mike Tyson. The nigga who beat niggas up for a living and bite ears off.
You furthers yourself from being a homosexual or thinking you may like.
You think you like, what the hell is this nigga talking about?
Homosexuals.
Nah, I'm straight as an arrow. I'm just saying, you know.
Hold on, look at old dude.
Straight as an arrow.
This whole time I ain't even have it that way. What the hell?
I'm saying, you know.
I'm not saying love, but why really, do you have, really, if you're straight, why do you?
I really commented on the Dwayne Wade situation, because I got offended because it's a child, you know. That's why I really got offended, you know, and that's why I really said if it was a motherfucking 19-year-old, 18-year-old grown person, I probably would. I know I wouldn't have said nothing.
Why did you?
But
say
I felt like he. I felt like. You know,
I'm just saying, you know, I'm not judging you.
Yeah.
Don't ever think I'm here judging you. I'm just trying to
understand. Bruh, niggas always judge you, talking about I'm not judging you. Niggas would be like, no offense, but say some offensive ass shit. Niggas would be like, no homo, say some gay ass shit. Man, just shut the fuck up. You know what I'm saying? Niggas always want to talk about something. And it be the shit that don't even matter for real.
Understand you.
Yeah.
You know, and I got some demons. You ain't in my world when it comes to demons.
Yeah.
Okay. Why he said it like that? You not in my world when it comes to demons. This nigga could be fighting demons. I don't know. This nigga look weird as hell. It's always a story behind the weird nigga or an odd person. You know what I'm saying?
Okay, but just tell me why.
It was just like, you know, I just felt like,
nigga, what the hell your ass for, Mike Tyson? What the hell your ass for, bro? Where the hell you from, little bro? Oh, this nigga from Brooklyn. I mean, sound
like,
all right.
Yo, that's a child. I feel like a child ain't. At 12, can't make that decision. I felt like
what the hell was I doing at 12? When I was 12, I was just doing the same shit. Trying to get me some money, minding my business. Shit. I don't know. I probably was on YouTube when I was 12. I've been on YouTube, so shit. But when you 12, you really don't know nothing for real though. You just kid.
But like, that's just how I feel. You know, and certain things I talk about on like that, I just feel like that was going too far. You know,
I agree with you.
You calling him or her, you know, like that's just going too far, you know, at 12 years old. Like,
this is a weird ass interview. This is the first 2020 interview I've seen in black and white. I ain't never seen no goddamn interview in black and white in 2020. Weird as hell. This nigga weird as hell. It's something about this nigga we don't know.
But check this out. I agree with you 100%, right? I agree with you, right?
I don't know. This nigga voice throwing me off. It's like, nigga talk like Michael Jackson.
Me, I agree with you. But check this out.
Let me see if I'm
talking about it, say anything. We can't, you know, what I think don't mean a motherfucker.
You can see that. At least Gucci's just stands for what he said. You can see the hurt in his eyes.
I'm like Tyson. You know what I mean?
Tyson is someone in my generation respect.
But I created this fucking image of I ain't like
Tyson. It's not Gucci being fucked.
Whatever people think I am, but I know I put some.
I'm 13 years old. I refuse to just.
I put some scary shit out there. I know it's out there, you know, because I'm afraid. That's what kind of.
I'm like, ugly, and then get your stupid and goof ass on, boy. But that's me, cause I don't know, bro. I'm hanging here. You know what I'm saying? But I know what he's saying. He talking what he gotta say, cause he an OG.
You know, we have to know who we really are. We think we know who we are. You know.
Why the nigga got his fucking finger in his mouth? You dirty ass nigga. It's Corona, nigga. You nasty ass nigga. Coronavirus. Nigga, y'all don't got no mask in that bitch.
Who the fuck are we to make a comment about somebody's life? Who are you? What happened to you that you think that you're somebody to make a comment on somebody's life? I used to think that I can make a comment on somebody's life.
My mama said the same thing.
Yeah.
She said, who am I? Think I can make a comment about somebody else's child. But, you know, I said it and I stand on what I said.
Really?
Yeah, I said it, and I stand on.
Bro, you see what the hell going on right there? He trying to make his ass apologize or something? This nigga like, really? Fuck.
I said it, and I stand on.
I respect Boosie. I ain't gonna care. Boosie, man, he real deal OG. Nigga don't be Murray K. Nigga don't be cancer. Nigga don't be everything. You know what I'm saying? Nigga beats having hell of fucking baby mamas. You know what I'm saying? This nigga's an OG, like I said. And Mike Tyson there trying to get in his head, trying to make him apologize on TV so this shit could go all around the media, bro. What the hell type lame ass shit is this? Of course you're going to get a ear-biting ass nigga to convince a nigga like Boosie. Bro, Boosie too solid, bro.
What I said?
Boosie too
really?
Solid.
Yeah, I said it and I stand on what I
think that just somebody to make a comment on somebody's
watch it
life.
Again, bro.
I used to think that I can make a comment on somebody's life.
My mama said the same thing.
Yeah.
She said, who am I? Think I could make a comment about somebody.
Really? Fuck.
But you know, I said it and I stand on what I say.
Really?
Really?
Yeah, I said it, man. I stand on what I say. I just feel like.
Are you sure you don't want to apologize? Boosie. Come on now. Think about it. Come on, bro.
You know what? That's a 12-year-old child.
For real. Four Boosie. Real stand on it. Now, let's look at the Vlad interview. He just posted the interview.
I can see every color in you, and I can feel every color in me.
Yeah. What a beast is the room. Wow. Oh my God, you got your whole little thing going on here, huh?
Yeah.
I just want to check it out. That's all. That's good. You comfortable?
Mm-hmm.
Alhamdulillah.
me.
Oh, wow.
Everything is raw, live, and uncooked, man. And whatever happens, happens. Y'all ain't seen the side video when my dad just walked in and made that whole shit weird. I don't even know the bird, but I remember, bro was touching my hair like this. You got checked, you gotta cut your hair. I'm like, bro, I don't know you. Don't know your ass, but at least you saying.
Right. And I remember you did the video about the, you know, don't cut his dick off and everything else like that. And a lot of pushback came back from that. At one point, I guess you were saying on The Breakfast Club that Jay-Z wanted to talk to you about it and you didn't want to have that conversation.
Nah, it wasn't.
And they got down Mike Tyson as to go get his head. Yeah, I don't speak to Boosie.
People
don't set his ass up. Case.
Oh, they crossed it. They put this shit wrong. The guy who I own my reality show with, right? He know Jay. When we start losing advertisers, he like, man, I'm gonna call Jay. Jay can put you on the line.
Illuminati.
With Dwayne Wade and y'all do some shit and.
I don't care. Nobody say niggas say Jay-Z. I think Illuminati. I ain't even gonna care. Boy, y'all don't remember them Illuminati videos used to be on YouTube, but middle school day, boy. This nigga King of Illuminati. You know what I'm saying? Devil worshiper type. This nigga Boosie, real nigga. This nigga too solidified. This nigga too 100.
I don't feel like I said nothing wrong to him.
Remember that time the nigga said, remember he had an interview with Vlad? He was talking about, yeah, I was gonna go to the death row chair, a hero, for not snitching. Not snitching on Marlo Mike and all that. All the murders and shit like that. Bro, who the... Boy, I'm in my way though, man. We in the office ready to... Nigga be ready to pop in that motherfucking in that shank. But just wait. Muscles pay off. Ooh, I'm be flexing on these niggas. Ooh, like Hercules. Take these nigga bitches like Johnny Bravo. Yeah, you did live in the beach. Bro, that's the type of time I'm on. Hey, I hope these videos don't get copyrighted, bro. I'm gonna be mad as hell if my videos get copyrighted. They done block like two of my videos. They done block the Gucci Man video and Ariana Grande video. And the Ariana Grande video was Liddy and everything. But I was in that bitch dancing like, ooh, talking my shit like, baby, Ariana, I don't want you type shit. And they fucking blocked me. That shit lame in here. But I'm doing this shit for fun. And I ain't really chill about no block, man. You can block me all that room, but I'm boy, still coming and not playing with these niggas. You did. I don't know what this nigga saying now, but I
just hey, that Lucy
interview anyways. They read on set that nigga with Mike Tyson on them gay comments. They not playing with his ass. Bye bye. Bye. Y'all like, comment, subscribe, all that good shit.